Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. This week, I'll focus on bringing in a simple vector and show you how to group the shape layer version of that vector. We're going to convert this vector into a shape layer, and then what I want to do is I want to break it down so that you have a better understanding of the way shape layers are grouped and how they are ordered within After Effects. And then once you have that understanding, it's much easier to animate these vectors. With this highlighted, we're going to go to Layer, Create Shapes from Vector Layer. And once again, this is going to create multiple groups within one shape layer for every element within that shape layer. After Effects automatically hides this layer here, and we can actually get rid of that. And the contents we see here are all of our groups. The layer you see on top is going to be the first group here, and the last group here is going to be the layer that's behind everything else. This group 18, as we can see, this is our background. Okay, in group 17, that's our shadow. We can go ahead and just delete both of those. So now if you wanted to stop here, you actually could grab all this, go to animation, save animation preset, save it as camera, which I've already done. And then we'll have it over here in our animation presets. This is our camera shape layer. But what if you want to do things like you want to animate this button here, or the focal ring to turn, things like that. If you want to kind of mess with the color of the background, maybe you want to change this button to a different color. It's a little time consuming the first time you do it. But the great thing about these presets is that once you've created the shape layer with all of your keyframes and everything else, all you have to do next time is bring it right back in. So you really only have to animate this one time. Unfortunately, with shape layers, you can't just kind of click on certain areas and see what you're working with. After Effects sees this as really like one image. So we want to create new groups. Whenever you add a group, it automatically brings it to the very bottom. Let's go to Contents, Add Group, and we want to start from the back and move forward. This group we'll call Body. And the way you rename this, you just highlight the group, hit Enter, and it lets you rename it. Although when you click around, you can't really see what group is being accessed. When you click on the group under the shape layer, you can. Group 10 is this flash button here. Group 14 is this button. So we're going to use that to kind of guide us through this grouping of this image. So group 16, that's our body. And you just want to drag that right into the body group. Let's add another group. I'm going to move that right above body. The best way to do this is go to group 15 and see this is going to be our left button. So we'll rename group 17. Left button. Now, what I consider the left button is both this lighter gray and this darker gray piece, which is group, as we can see, 14 and 15. So we can grab both of those, drag it into left button. Now, group 12 and 13 is going to be our right button. Add another group, bring it above, call this right button. We're going to grab group 12 and 13 and bring it right in here. We can actually grab this and drag this into our body group as well. We need group 11 to be on top of group 16 in order to see it. Okay, so group 10, that's our flash button. Now, whenever a group only has one element, there's no need to make another group. So we can just rename group 10 as flash. Okay, group 9, if we hide that, we see it's just this upper part here, which is also a part of the body. And see, if you hide the body, you can see now that it contains all three of those elements. Group 8, this outer ring. Group 7, it's gonna be this inner ring. Group 6, that's actually going to be our lens. Okay, so now let's, we need to add a group, bring it above lens. We'll call this reflection. So that's 2, 3, 4, and 5. And finally, group 1, that looks like our power button. So now the benefit to this is now we have complete control over every element of this camera, meaning we can animate each element. We can change colors. You have transform properties that affect the entire shape layer itself, but we want to focus more on these transform properties for each element. So now what you can do is if you press Y for your pan behind tool, it's also to move your anchor point. So let's grab that and we're gonna put it right in the middle. Now, if we go to our left button, scroll back, see it's up here as well. So let's bring that and scroll in. And we want our anchor point to go right at the bottom here. Same thing with our right button. Our flash, see, we see our anchor point is already centered. Our outer ring is already centered, inner ring as well. Lens, reflection up here. So we're gonna bring that to the middle. And then our power button, yes, it's centered as well. Go to our transform property for left button. We had a keyframe for position. Go about 10 frames, and we want to bring it down, get another 10 frames, and bring it back up. Whenever we come down, our button is going on top of our camera body. So what we want to do, we're going to bring this right and left button below the layer for the for our body of our camera. So now, see, it just disappears. See how it clicks like that. So by being able to control each element of the shape layer, we can do all kinds of things. Look at this outer ring here. Maybe what we want to do is we want it to spin. We use a transform property for power button. We can do scale. If we grab all this, go to animation, save animation preset. So I would put this in vector shape layer, call this camera 2. Okay, so now let's get rid of these contents. Watch, we can bring this back in. There's our camera with the colors that we changed them to. And if you hit U, you can see the keyframes that we put down. So even though this took a little bit of work, whenever I want to use this camera again, instead of bringing in this vector and doing all that all over again, all I have to do is bring in a shape layer, grab camera 2, and drag it over. I also mentioned that these shape layers also have their own transform properties for the entire shape layer. What I meant by that was if you click your shape layer and say you hit P, S, or R for position, scale, and rotation, these transform properties are for the entire image. So see if you spin that around, if you make this larger. But just be aware that the shape layer itself has transform properties, but also each group has its own transform properties. And one of the cool things about shape layers, like vector images, they are scalable to any size. Shape layers are by default already rasterized. You can make this as big as you want and you will lose no quality whatsoever. And there you have it. Creating shapes from vector layers is yet another very powerful tool within After Effects. If you use similar vectors on a regular basis, I would highly recommend building a library of shape layer presets. I hope this helped you out. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything you'd like to see. Thanks everybody, and I'll see you next time.